Hello and welcome to Yes We Can, Learning Opportunity in Crisis. We are studying Chapter 1 of Class 5 EVS, Super Senses. This chapter is divided into three parts and this is Part 3. In Part 1, we have discussed about super sense of smell in animals. In Part 2, we have discussed super sense of sight and hearing in animals. Now, we'll study about super sense of touch. Let's do an activity. Sit near a desk. Tap the desk once with your hand. Listen carefully. Now put your ear on the desk as shown in the picture. Tap on the desk once again with your hand. Listen again. Was there any difference in the sound of the tap? Yes, there is a difference. You'll feel some vibration of sound. Vibration means some movement produced in the air and in your ears. This is how snakes hear. Snakes do not have external ears. They feel the vibrations on the ground. That is how snakes hear. Similarly, when a snake charmer plays the bean, snakes cannot hear the bean. They dance in defense when the bean moves. Next is creatures with sensitive senses. Some animals go into a long, deep sleep in certain seasons. Then they are not seen for many months. Have you noticed that during the cold season, you cannot see any lizard in your house? Where do you think they have gone? This long sleep is called hibernation. I repeat, hibernation. It is a state of inactivity when some animals go into deep sleep during cold winter months to survive harsh winter conditions when food is short. Let us see some more animals which hibernate. They are turtle, bat, frog, snake, bear, squirrel, snail, bee. Now about sloth. Sloth is an animal which looks like a bear but is not. It is a sloth. It spends almost 17 hours a day sleeping while hanging upside down on a tree branch. The sloth eats the leaves of the same tree on which it lives. When it has eaten enough leaves from the tree, it moves to the nearby tree. Sloths live for about 40 years and in that time they move around only 8 trees. Once a week it comes down from the tree to relieve itself. How can you show the sleeping time and the time for which the sloth is awake in a clock? You know that there are 24 hours in a day. This is a circle which is divided into 12 parts. Each part denotes 2 hours. So 12 into 2 is equal to 24 hours. In this picture, the shaded part is showing the sleeping time and the non-shaded part is showing the time for which the sloth is awake. So let us count. How many parts are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Each part is of 2 hours. So 2 plus 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 2 is equal to 18 hours. That is 2 into 9 is equal to 18 hours. In your book it is written almost 17 hours, means it can be 18 hours also. So the sleeping time of sloth is 18 hours. Given here is the sleeping time of some animals. Write below each picture for how many hours a day that animal sleeps. The first picture is showing the sleeping time of cow. The shaded parts show the sleeping time. And you know, each part is of 2 hours. Now count the number of parts shaded. 1, 2. That means 2 into 2 is equal to 4 hours. The cow sleeps for 4 hours. Next is the picture of python. How many parts are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That means 2 into 9 is equal to 18 hours. The python sleeps for 18 hours. Similarly, in the picture of giraffe, only one part is shaded. So 2 into 1 is equal to 2 hours. Oh, then giraffe sleeps so less. And the last picture is of cat. How many parts are shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means 2 into 6 is equal to 12 hours. That means cat sleeps for 12 hours. We have studied about many super senses and have seen that tiger has almost all the super senses. Tiger can see 6 times better at night than the humans. A tiger's sense of hearing is so sharp that it can make out the difference between the rustling of leaves and the sound of an animal moving on the grass. The ears of the tiger can move in different directions, and this helps to catch the sounds from all around. Each tiger has its own area, which may cover several kilometers. Tigers mark their area with their urine. A tiger can at once come to know if there is another tiger in its area by the smell of the urine. A tiger will avoid going into another tiger's area, and then its whiskers can sense the sounds and vibrations in the air and help the tiger move in the dark and find its prey. The tiger is one of the most alert animals, and yet today tigers are in danger. The number of tigers and many other animals in our country is reducing. There is a danger that some of them will soon disappear. The animals whose number is decreasing at a very fast rate and are likely to be extinct. Extinct means they will not be seen anymore. Are called endangered animals. Let us see some more endangered animals. Pangolin, giant panda, rhinoceros, snow leopard, mountain gorilla, sea turtle. And then blue whale, tooth-billed pigeon, ghadiyal, orangutan, Atlantic bluefin tuna, Asian elephants. These are all endangered animals, means they are all likely to be extinct. We have seen that tiger and other animals have super senses, and tiger is one of the most alert animals. But why are they in danger? At the beginning of the 20th century, there were 1 lakh tigers in the world. Today, this number is estimated to have reduced to around 3,900 in the wild. Hunters and poachers are the biggest threat. People who kill animals are called hunters and poachers. Next reason is deforestation, means cutting of trees. Most of the animals live in forests. Cutting of trees from the forest leads to loss of habitat. Habitat means the place where they live. Do you know that today many animals are killed and their parts are sold? Tigers are killed for their skin, for home decor and status symbol. Tigers are also killed for their claws and teeth to make pendants for necklaces. Likewise, snakes are killed for their skin to make many things like shoes, belts, purse, jewelry. Rhinoceros is killed for horns, mainly to be used as a medicine and as a status symbol. Elephants are killed for tusk used for manufacturing piano and organ keys, billiard balls, handles and objects of decorative value. Musk deer is killed for scent. Musk is a substance obtained from the male musk deer and has a strong smell. It is used in the highest grades of perfume. Musk is obtained from the musk pod in a pouch under the skin of the abdomen of the male musk deer. Fresh musk is semi-liquid but dries to a grainy powder. How to save animals? To protect the animals, our government has made some forests as protected areas. These are called national parks and sanctuaries. In these areas, nobody can hunt animals or destroy the jungle. There are many national parks in our country. I'll show you some of them. This is the map of India showing national parks in India. Let us start from the east. In Assam, Kaziranga National Park. In Uttarakhand, Jim Corbett National Park. In Rajasthan, Ghana National Park and Ranthambore National Park. In Gujarat, Gir National Park. Maharashtra, Sanjay Gandhi National Park. Karnataka, Bandipur National Park. Kerala, Periyar National Park. Tamil Nadu, Madhumalai National Park. West Bengal, Sundarban. Jharkhand, Hazaribagh National Park. And Madhya Pradesh, Kanha National Park. You do not see in the same way an eagle does. You do not touch in the same way a cat does. You do not taste in the same way a butterfly does. You do not smell in the same way an ant does. And you do not hear in the same way an elephant does. But you can learn about all of these animals through your own very senses. Now let us try to find out, do you have super senses? Would you be able to find your food or escape from predators in the dark? Go to the darkest room in your home, turn off the lights, let your eyes adjust for a moment. What do you see? What do you hear? What do you smell? Would you be able to navigate your way around the room without bumping into something? So, this is the end of part 3, and in this part we have learnt about super sense of touch, creatures with sensitive senses, winter sleep in animals, sleeping hours of animals, about sloth, endangered animals, why tigers are in danger, and national parks. Worksheet is given at the end and link to the other parts are given in the description box. Here we finish our chapter. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask me in the comment section. I'll reply as soon as possible. See you soon with chapter 2. Thanks for watching. Do like and subscribe my channel, Yes We Can, Learning, Opportunity in Crisis, for more upcoming videos.